Well, here the arena's all set. The crowd has packed in. There are still a few empty seats because there's still competition just finishing outside for the working and pastoral group. Some of the dogs won't have finally got through yet, and so their connections will still be taking up their seats in the main stand. But it is pretty full here. There's over 6,000 people already in, and it will be packed. There'll be 23 dogs taking part in the working group. And it's a little early judging the working group, earlier than we've normally had it. And so we may be struggling occasionally to find out which dogs have come through. I've got Frank Kane sitting beside me, and Frank knows most of these dogs. I think he knows them all by name and by connections.
Well,
and
wishful thinking, Peter.
Yeah, no, but he does have somewhat more knowledge than I do on a lot of these dogs. But we're really looking forward to receiving the paperwork. Here it comes. Oh, bless, that's wonderful. Thanks, Sarah. So we do have things. We're safe. Saved at the end there. And I hope they're all there. They may well be. So, so the working group will be coming in for judging very shortly, and will be followed then by the pastoral group. And I love these big dogs. These are the giants of the dog world that come in the working group and the pastoral group. My own particular favorite, of course, being well documented as being the Newfoundland. And Frank, as best in show judge last year, did put a Newfoundland up as reserve best in show. I thought that was wonderful. He's a very good judge, you know. Anyway, he's had the honour of judging the utility group this year, and he'll be in the big ring, although he will get back for best in show for most of it, but he will be in the big ring at the start of the best in show judging. So, Frank, you like these big fellas as well, don't you?
I certainly do. I've had a marvellous day going around the rings today, Peter. Lots of foreign dogs here. Makes a really international atmosphere, and a lot of overseas dogs winning, and we'll be seeing a lot of them here.
Well, there have been more foreign entries than ever before, haven't there?
And it gives a great international feeling to Crufts. You know, they all come here because it's the one they want to win at. It's the world's most prestigious dog show, and they love the atmosphere, and they love a win here. A win here means a lot for the prestige of the dog.
Talking about the atmosphere, it has been absolutely electric. This main arena has been full most of the day. Yesterday, absolutely packed solid every inch of the day. Well, it looks like we're heading for that again now for the final stages of the competition. This is when it really does get exciting, and it's great entertainment. Everyone seems to absolutely love it. And I'm keeping my fingers crossed that perhaps one of my favourite breeds may come through out of the working group. But if it doesn't, well, what does come through is certain to be wonderful, because we have an extremely experienced judge for the working group. She says it's her last year, Mrs. Ferrelith Summerfield. Is that likely, do you think?
Yes, she is going to retire this year. Yeah. She's a wonderful judge. She has been for years a great ambassador for English judges overseas, and very knowledgeable and a wonderful dog lady.
Well, in fact, she was best in show judge here in the past, hasn't she? And she has judged every single group. Last time she judged the working group was back in 1988, when, of course, it was combined with the pastoral group. It was a massive group then.
And she's second generation. Her mother was a famous dog person too. And Ferrelith's been in dogs since she was a schoolgirl.
Well, we're now awaiting the moment that the working dogs do come in. And we have a full group, we're told, but there is a delay because there are three dogs haven't. That you see, the judging here at Crufts, it takes place in the giant halls 1 to 5 at the NEC in Birmingham, and it does mean that when you have a large entry, and some of these entries are very big indeed, even with these big breeds, they don't always get their judging finished in time. But here they are. It looks like they have got everything ready. Here come the first dog. We'll see where we are at least. So, Frank, stand by, hold on to your hats. Here we go with the working group. To hand you over to Mr. Keith Young. Keith Young is the ring announcer here, and he's going to be introducing, first of all, he'll introduce our judge, who we've just been talking about. So I will introduce her at the same time for you.
Before we see the dogs into the ring, it's my great pleasure, on behalf of the Crufts Committee, to introduce the judge. Without doubt, she is one of the ladies of dogdom and one of UK's best loved and most respected and popular judges. She first awarded CCs in 1964 in Cairn Terriers and is now approved to award CCs in over 140 breeds as well as being approved to judge all the groups and best in show. Indeed, she has previously judged all the groups here at Crufts, and in 1990, she judged best in show. I think it's appropriate to mention
Keith
that
Young
after
repeating
such
more
a
or less what Frank and I were talking about the judge, and she will be coming into the ring in a moment. We'll get the great ovation from this crowd because she is one of the most experienced judges in the country.
Ladies and gentlemen, please give an extra warm Crufts welcome to Mrs. Fairless Summerfield.
And here comes our judge, escorted into the ring by Gerald King, who's chairman of the Crufts Committee. And here she is, Mrs. Fairless Summerfield. As we say, one of the most experienced judges in the world, and retiring from judging. This is her last Crufts, and she has judged everything, all the groups, and best in show. So totally experienced. Who can gainsay her? So here come the dogs that she's going to have to judge.
We are now ready to see the best of breed dogs for this, the working group, being led in by the...
And here's the Alaskan Malamute coming in first. Big cheer for that.
Followed by one of the prettiest breeds, the Bernese Mountain Dog.
And here comes the Bouvier de Flandre.
Followed by one of the very popular breeds, the Boxer.
The Bull Mastiff.
Another of the bull breeds, the Bull Mastiff, trotting in.
And the Canadian Eskimo Dog.
Big cheers for the Doberman.
The Dog de Bordeaux.
The German Pinscher.
German Pinscher. One of the more rare breeds in the group.
The Great Dane.
One of the giants of the world, dog world, the Great Dane.
The Greenland Dog.
One of the sled dogs, the Greenland Dog, is coming now. Only a few of these here, they're quite a rare breed.
The Hovervart.
And the Hovervart. Well, actually, well, that's the Liamberger.
It certainly is. He's got them out of order there.
Wrong.
The Mastiff.
Here comes the Brindle Mastiff, as we used to call it, the Old English Mastiff.
The Newfoundland.
Followed by the Newfoundland. Oh, I love
Portuguese
it.
Water dog.
And another water dog from Portugal this time. This is the Portuguese water dog.
And the instantly recognisable, the Rottie, the Rottweiler.
Very controlled coming
the
in there.
Black Terrier.
Relatively modern breed, the Russian Black Terrier.
The Hovervart.
Now comes the Hovervart.
He's a little out of sequence. I don't think he found them. Yes, he's from Czech Republic and doesn't speak English, so I think he's been lost. The Neapolitan Mastiff. This is a forbidding presence.
Isn't it, though?
The St. Bernard.
The St. Bernard. Oh, and what a round of applause for that gorgeous-looking animal.
And finally, the Tibetan Mastiff.
And last but not least, the Tibetan Mastiff.
That completes the dogs in the group, so I'll now hand over to my colleagues, Jonathan Daltrey and Annette Oliver, for further commentary. Thank you.
As you saw, some of the dogs came in out of order as Fairless Summerfield now goes to take a look along the line. She'll take a nice leisurely look along the line of dogs, give herself an idea of where she might go with her judging. An important part, you've done this, Frank,
this
is an important part of the judging.
This is the part where the judge takes in the overall balance and general appearance of the dog, and this is where you get the stamp of breed type. Is it the right shape for the breed?
Look at that Bernese there, gorgeous colouring.
The Bouvier and the Smart Boxer, two very famous judges for the boxers today. The Bull Mastiff looking at them kindly. Canadian Eskimo Dog and Doberman, smart, clean-cut outline. And the Dog de Bordeaux. There's the German Pinscher, that looks very smart. Four Great Dane bitch, lovely elegance there. Greenland
the
dog.
Greenland dog in there.
Some of the most dogs in the world,
a whole number of these Spitz type.
Beautiful Leonberger.
And there's the Mastiff. And the Newfie with a nice... Has it got the flash on the front?
It's like white mark, quite permissible,
oh,
small
yes.
one.
And on the toes, I'm told, as well.
And the... This looks a very nice Rottweiler. You notice the now that they're undocked.
And that's the Russian Black Terrier, as you say, a comparatively recent breed to be judged here in at Crufts.
And there's the Hovervart. Farm dog from Germany.
Well, probably H comes there in Czechoslovakia. It doesn't come up near the front.
And the Tibetan Mastiff.
Mrs. Summerfield then taking a look at the first dog in the group. This is Jason, who is a 2-year, 7-month-old dog owned by Tony Quillison and Annette Rost. Come from Denmark. The handler in the ring is Even Gratz, and the breeder is Turid Teigen from Norway, for continental dog.
A beautiful headshot there of the Alaskan Malamute. Strong skull and those pricked ears.
From the rugged western area of Alaska, one of the world's really hardy dog. His job is to pull sledges. Not fast, but immensely strong.
This is the heavyweight of the sledging dogs. It can pull very big loads. Great substance in those hindquarters and a tail like a waving plume. Their harsh and thick double coat is vital for protection against extreme weather. Now there he goes striding out. He should have great power in those hindquarters and strong shoulders for pulling. Strong bone holding that level top line. Slightly sloping from the withers.
Unmistakable Breeze, the Bernese Mountain Dog. It's a bitch, 2¾ years old, owned by Mrs. M. Mayer, Mrs. Carol Hartley Mayer from Rochdale in Lancashire, handled in the ring by Gary Dryball, and Mrs. Mayer and Carol and Hartley Mayer bred this one.
Very smart, the Bernese Mountain Dogs, a general farm dog in Germany, in this distinctive markings, black, tan and white. And it's said that the white marking on the chest resembles the flag on the cross on the Swiss flag. Beautiful head.
Do you think that might be an afterthought?
I think it's a bit of canine folklore, Peter, but it's a nice piece. But they are wonderfully natured breed, very popular as family pets.
They are lovely big animals, lovely rolling gait, isn't that nice?
And this kennel, very successful, they live up near Rochdale. I think they were best of breed here last year, and it may well have been this bitch. She's only 2½, and she was very young. Interesting, Gary the handler is a vet and very keen on pedigree dogs, so that's good to hear. Bernese Mountain Dog, 15617.
This is the Bouvier de Flandre. He's called Floyd, 3-year-old dog, owned by Eric and Jean Zweifernick, I think that is. Handled by Eric, who is the owner. Eric Zweifernick, I'll try that again, Zweifernick, I think that's right. He also bred this dog.
And he's come over from Holland, where the breed is very strong. Strong in the skull, this wonderful matte coat. Very versatile. The Bouvier means a cattle dog. They originally bred to drive cattle to market, but then became very adaptable in the First World War. They were used as messenger dogs and as guard dogs, and there Ferelith checking the bone and feet on the dog.
They never come in brindle, these do they? They're always fawn to black. Oh, they do come in brindle. All the shades from fawn to black.
And a hardy, even-tempered dog emerged. Droving sheep and cattle and pulling carts are just a few of this breed's many talents.
Strong head and expression there.
A rugged, powerful dog. Originally used for herding and protecting cattle in Belgium.
And we'll now see his purposeful gait. And a very happy gait on this one. So that coat is dry and matte, so dense you can hardly feel the skin under it, and that's correct for the breed. They're usually a dark colour. They prefer the darker shades of fawn. This, the dark grey brindle, Peter.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, the best of breed winning Bouvier. 157, 2-2.
Well, the best of breed in the boxes was Asbo, who's a three-year-old dog, owned by Mandy Laidlaw and Gemma Stockton from the Isle of Man. Gemma Stockton handling, Mandy Laidlaw was the breeder. 1cc, so maybe that was today.
The best of breed is this dog, number 15822. Developed in Germany, it's believed
and
that
huge entry in the boxes today. Two judges for them, two very famous boxer breeders. This one, the bitches were judged by Tim Hutchings. Noble head, clean neck and shoulders, and looking alertly. The boxers are great characters and love fun, as you know. Okay, there's nice movement coming and enjoying it, wagging his tail. The boxer should essentially be short and square in the body, slightly sloping from the withers, that padded muzzle, clean skull, and striding out with a hard top line.
Lovely, fun-loving dog, showing its true personality there as it trots around the ring. Well, there is the Bull Mastiff. She's called Minnie, five-year-old bitch, owned by Heid Kjeldby from Norway. It's probably Hilda Kjeldby, and she's the breeder as well. First CC in the UK today.
And this looks beautiful. One of the taller of the bull breeds, this lovely strong skull, short muzzle. The judge just checking the mouth. The dentition has to be correct and strong.
It was the wardens and gamekeepers of large country estates who developed the breed in the
1960s. Very lovely dark eyes and kind expression.
Said the ancestors of this, dogs like the Great Dane as well. But a nice older breed of dog, this one.
Now, Ferulith going over the conformation of the dog. She's feeling the angulation in the hindquarters, which equips it to move well. Looking for strong hocks and strong bone and good angulation in the shoulders. And striding out nicely and a beautiful temperament. This looks very nice when it came in. Lovely proportions and balance. If the dog's balanced forehand and rear, then they'll keep that top line on the move, and that's striding out well.
That's a lovely top line, isn't it? Mr. Summerfield enjoying that.
Jill Peake was the judge of the Canadian Eskimo dogs. And from nine dogs, Jill selected...
Well, this is the Canadian Eskimo dog. It's Rufus, who is a 3.5-year-old dog. Mrs. Elizabeth Salter has brought from Thetford in Norfolk. David Salter handling in the ring, and Anne Allen was the breeder. No CCs.
And there, the dentition being checked again. You can see that lovely wedge-shaped head, almond-shaped eyes, and those pricked furred ears, furred inside to give them protection against the climate.
It's a lovely coat, isn't it?
They are bred for long-distance work, not for speed. They're fairly solidly built. Permitted to let their tail hang down when it rests, they'll bring it up when they're moving.
As we see...
There we are, striding out now, and the tails come up over the back. That tail in harsh weather, when they curl up to sleep outside, the tail is wrapped around them to give them protection. All functional.
The Doberman. Two judges for this popular breed, Stuart Ballard in the dog ring with 78 and Keith Baldwin, 97.
Satchmo here is a three-year-old Doberman dog. Owned by Sue Thorne from Charfield in Gloucestershire, handled and bred by her as well. First CC today, proud moment.
Selector Louis Doberman is credited with developing this breed in the late 1860s. He needed a dog that would both protect him and encourage.
And a beautiful, clean, wedge-shaped head is what we're looking for. 42 teeth, important in the breed. They like that in the German breed. It's very strict on teeth.
Very elegant and popular breed, isn't it?
It should be squarely built, and we saw a lovely picture of its outline. Clean neck into shoulder, runs smoothly from behind the skull into the withers. Very elegant.
Beautiful short, hard coat. Very easy to care for in terms of the coat, isn't it?
Yes, it's usually they're very glossy and easy to keep. There's very little grooming attached to this breed. Yes, there he goes, striding out, holding a firm top line, should hold that shape on the move. Very alert. Tail carried correctly, slightly above the level of the back.
So moving from Germany, we visit France. Here we see the Doge de Bordeaux.
This is the Doge de Bordeaux. Very little information about it because it was a late arrival. International multi-champion Bakerville-style funky boy, owned by Mrs. MSA Barker from Holland.
There's a beautiful shot of the head. This is a cousin of the Bull Mastiff, but smaller. They should be athletic. They come only in these shades of fawn. This one a rich fawn. A little bit of wrinkle permitted when alert on the head. Well-padded muzzle. They're not gigantic dogs. They should be fairly low set, strong bone and feet.
And this breed, of course, the popular star of a movie not so long ago.
Now, there we are, that typical top line. We have this slight rise to the hindquarters and fall away. Now it's quite interesting, when this breed moves, they should drop the head and get the head lower and retaining that slight rise in the top line, doing it perfectly here.
Popularized in film and on TV, the Doge is even-tempered, protected by nature, vigilant without aggression. 16257, the best of breed winning Doge de Bordeaux.
Very smart indeed.
One of the smaller members of the group, this is the German Pinscher. Din is a 13-month-old dog, nice and young. Cindy Benson and Ben Pierce own this dog in Grays, Essex. Cindy is the handling. Jay and Martin Morgan with the breeders. No CCs to date.
Now the German Pinscher, the German breed. The word Pinscher means terrier, but of course these are leggier and bigger than our terriers. But they were used as general farm dogs and for ratting. There. I'm always surprised that this has not become more popular. You know, we have the miniature Pinscher in the toy group. This is this middle size of Pinschers. And they're very adaptable for living in the house and lovely temperament. Lovely wedge-shaped head there.
Nice good reach in front there and a nice rotary action on the move.
Great Dane. 138 Great Danes with 153 entries for Lawrence Walker.
Unmistakable, this bitch is a Great Dane. She's called Roma, she's 2.5 years old. Owned by Heidi Lund and Roger Salsted from Norway. Another Norwegian dog here, handled by Heidi in the ring, and the two of them bred the dog. and 10 cc's, so a good winner this one.
And over from Norway, so a first raid for this, and this looks a lovely bitch. Beautiful head, this long, clean head, very important. They should have a degree of elegance combined with substance. The well-curved back leg, which gives it power when it moves.
We've just said dignified, but the cartoon character Scooby-Doo is, of course, a great dame.
There's a beautiful shot. Kind expression. Looking rather wise at all of this. Many people think that the Great Dane is a Danish dog. It was actually developed in Germany. That lovely brick-shaped long head, which is very desirable.
Only introduced to the UK in 1877.
There you are. They should have an element of dash and dare. Be ready to go anywhere. This looks very good. To get a tall, long-legged breed moving with collection is one of the challenges. And this is really holding itself well together with a good top line.
And this is just one of the many colours. This is fawn, but they come in a number of different colours.
The second breed for Jill Peake to judge was the Greenland dog. There were 8 Greenland dogs, and it was number 16601 that Jill chose to represent the breed in today's working group finale.
This is the Greenland dog. He's called Cosmo. He's 2 years old. Mark Plummer comes from New York, Lincolnshire, that is, in the UK. Handled by Mark Plummer in the ring and bred by Mrs. Winston and Mrs. Singh.
Again, this is one of the rarer breeds in the group. They are an all-purpose draft dog, not as heavy as the Alaskan Malamute, which we saw earlier, but not as speedy as the Siberian Husky, which is coming on. But again, they're very functional. That weatherproof coat, furred ears, that tail which can be wrapped around it when it's sleeping in the severe climate. There you are. Very typical in its carriage, that tail carried over the back. They came in all colours, this breed. Only half a dozen of them here today.
It's one of the medium-sized sledge dogs, isn't it, this one?
So we move now to the Leonberger, judged today by Helen Davenport Willis.
This Leonberger is called Norris. He's 4 years old and owned by Natalia Kukashkaya from St. Petersburg in Russia. Fabulous part of the world over there. Handled by Gusiva Mariana, or rather Mariana Gusiva, and bred by Boris Kaskov.
Beautiful, very imposing breed. They're one of the giant breeds, and their name suggests where they were bred. The town of Leonberg in Germany originated from a crossing of the Newfoundland with the St. Bernard.
It's not as big as either, however, but it is a big dog.
They should be leonine in appearance. They come in this red or rusty coat, sometimes with a slight black overlay and a black mask. This is very impressive, combining substance with athleticism.
Wonderful, friendly dogs, everyone that I've met. Bo here is a 20-month-old Mastiff bitch owned by Mark and Pam Fox from Broadstairs in Kent, bred by them, and Mark Fox is handling in the ring. First CC today.
And this is a brindle. We're perhaps more used to seeing the fawns winning, but here's a very nice young brindle bitch. They were called the Old English Mastiff. They were developed to be gamekeepers' dogs against the poachers. Longer in the body than the Bull Mastiff, but that great strength in the bone and feet. But they should still be athletic enough to chase the poacher and frighten him off. That truncated muzzle, that short truncated muzzle and strong skull. This looks a very handsome young bitch. Longer body, level top line, one of the, you know, to get good length and a level firm top line, important. And this one is athletic. We can see it's a young bitch. She's not fully mature in the body, but she's got that degree of athleticism when she moves. Still a bit young by the looks of her movement.
This is a breed that's thought to have existed here in the UK since the time of the Romans. A mastiff.
Newfoundlands today were judged by Paddy Galvin. Paddy had 193.
This is Vic, 26-month-old dog, owned by Tom Gauter and Agneta van Luyken. They come from Belgium. Agneta's handling in the ring. Didier Hike was the breeder. Now got 1cc, first one in this UK. And what a lovely animal.
And this one looks young too, Peter. Looks a relatively young dog. I think just over 2 years of age.
Well, they don't mature till they're 4 months, 4 years, do they?
Now the head, strong skull, a slight stop between skull and foreface, and this dark eye. But above all, they were water dogs, so they have to be equipped to do that job. So they've got big barrel ribs to help them with flotation, working in the water, and an oily, weatherproof coat.
And webbed feet?
Webbed feet,
that
absolutely
helps
functional.
Swim.
And our judge just checking the depth of rib cage.
And there is a gorgeous Lancia painting on loan to the Kennel Club in the museum in Clarges Street of a Newfoundland.
Just there you are, looking at the weather. Ferulith just rubbing the coat back to see its oily, weatherproof quality.
The Lancia, which is black and white colour. Brown. What do you see here?
And striding out there. Now, they will, because of their barrel ribs, they'll get a slight rolling movement, and we can see it towing in slightly as it comes towards us. That's quite permitted in the breed.
And most distinctive.
Really is a gentle giant.
I've owned three of these. I absolutely adore the breed. As a puppy, it's like a cuddly teddy bear.
It was Sid Stevens who judged Portuguese water dogs today.
Indy here is a 7-year-old bitch. She's a Portuguese water dog owned by Mr. Sean Dring and Jenny Sword from Walsocombe in Cambridgeshire. Sean handling in the ring and Jenny was the breeder.
And there's another of the water breeds, the Portuguese water dog. These were developed to help the fishermen working from boats. They could dive off the boat and retrieve lost nets. Now we can see a little bit of the coat. They've got this flotation mane at the front. And clipped hind quarters we can see there.
These dogs still have a love for water today. They are bold, active, and devoted to their owners.
Immensely trainable dogs as well.
Now we'll see a very typical tail carriage. That tail has been left with a plume at the end, and that should be carried like a scimitar over the loins of the dog. That's one of the breed trademarks.
Max here is a 5-year-old dog owned by Graham Lees from Falkirk in Scotland, handled by Alistair Bailey today, and bred by Mr. and Mrs. Gordon Rattray.
And this is a very impressive outline here, Peter. Correct shape for the breed. Just slightly longer than square. Black and tan. You see the markings on the back leg there and under the tail. Strong bone and feet.
Now this lovely interesting spot just above the eye, don't they, which
tan eyebrows, yes,
clearly.
Translating to butcher's dog from Rottweil, the breed became known for its skills in droving and draft work, often pulling carts of fresh meat and other.
You wouldn't think looking at it there, it has a big undercoat as well, would you? Looks a very fine coat.
The first Rottweiler was imported from Germany into the USA in 1928.
And again, striding out nicely. This is a very collected dog, very calm. Was originally a drover's dog and a tax collector's dog. They get a bad press. They need intelligent owners, and they make intelligent dogs. Highly adaptable in for training.
Search and rescue, guide dogs, they're also used as police and guard dogs. The best of breed winning Rottweiler, 17206. We now move on to the Russian Black Terrier. Liz Dunhill is our judge today.
This was one of our late arrivals into the group, and unfortunately I have no information on it. I don't know it. It's a Russian black terrier, but looking at the name then, Malakshovarska Emishtalnaya Shtuchka, it's going to be a foreign dog.
I think it might be Russian, actually, yes, with syllables like that. Anyway, it looks a very handsome one, squarely built and a great substance.
This is very much a created breed, isn't it? Created for the Russian army to catch fugitives.
And relatively recent, only after the First World War.
Russian Black Terriers serve as police dogs, guard dogs in their native Russia. He has a waterproof.
There he goes. Now, they're very popular in Russia, Peter, very popular in Eastern Europe. They've got huge substance. You can hardly get your hand around the bone of the leg. Again, used as tracking dogs, very versatile.
The Russian Black Terrier, 17344.
Now we see the Hoverbart.
Out of place in the line, this is the Hoverbart, because we know H comes before R, but there we are. This is a five-year-old dog. I don't have a pet name for it. Owned by Mrs. L. Kunstrovka from the Czech Republic, and bred by Lenka Svobodova.
Yes, I saw this gentleman trying to find the collecting ring. That's perhaps why he was late. He doesn't speak a word of English. First time he's come. He's been to Crufts, and he's best of breed.
Great achievement for them.
This one, a black and gold. We can also get them in gold or blonde and plain black. This is a very handsome one.
But I'm told they're very strong-willed, so perhaps that's why they are less common than some of the other breeds.
The Hoverbart has many skills. They're good at guarding stock and property.
Another German breed. They were developed as general farm dogs, so very adaptable to herding or carting. Very calm temperament. This is a nice looking one. They're a pretty rare breed in this country.
Good worker in all weathers.
So from an ancient German breed, we move to an ancient Italian one, the Neapolitan Mastiff. There were 20 Neapolitans, the Jules, third breed to judge here today at Crufts.
King Louis here is a Neapolitan Mastiff. Pet name is Luke, and 20-month-old dog he is, owned by Sonia Schmidova from Belgium, and bred by Sonia Schmidova herself. Gabriel Ella Pavliskova is showing in the ring.
And very clean teeth, well-kept teeth there. Now, this is a breed which is very ancient, goes back to gladiatorial times, and they were used as gladiators' dogs for fighting in the arena. Pretty horrible, but a pretty imposing sight coming towards you, I would think. They used to lead the Roman legionnaires into battle with a big spiky collar on them.
Yeah, I could see that. I'd be frightened of it. Coming towards me with a big spiky collar.
Now, of course, they are one of the molossoid breeds, so they're heavy, heavily built. And, of course, they have been prone in the past to exaggeration. The breeders are working hard to get rid of excessive skin, which brings problems with it. A very elastic gait.
Eight 85 Savannahs entered under Mrs. Maggie Down, and her deliberations produced...
Sarah Farrell and Carol Schofield own Chunky here, a 20-month-old St. Bernard dog, and they come from Peterborough. Sarah's handling in the ring and was bred by the two, by Sarah Farrell and Hazel Lamb. Five cc's to its name.
And a very handsome one, still only a young dog. I saw this dog when it was a 10-week-old puppy, and they brought him to a seminar on the breed, and they said, what do you think of this? And they trotted him up and down. I said, that's amazing. He was so sound and a good mover at that age, so he's come on pretty well. So,
a long way to develop still, young dog, 20 months old. But they are lovely. I've been rescued by one of those in the snow.
I was going to say they were bred as rescue dogs. The legend, the rumour has it that they have a barrel of brandy round their neck, but I think that is a bit of folklore too.
I think it is. Well, I know it is.
Now, they have to have good length of leg, but also a strong body, strong skull and short muzzle. This one coming towards as well. Also comes in a smooth coated variety.
This is the Tibetan Massive, Pamela Jean Brown.
This is Chodak, who is a 5-year-old dog owned by Richard Gardner from Bridge End in South Wales. Richard showing, and the breeder was Sandra Heifel.
Described them as tall as a donkey with a voice as powerful as that of a lion. Now, I've not lived with one, so I don't know if that's true.
Now, this is the largest of the Tibetan breeds. Used as a guard dog, and again with a protective double coat, strong mane of hair over the neck and shoulders. This one a black and gold, come in a variety of colours. They are strong dogs and they need steady handling and bringing up well. That tail carried over the back. They are strong but also have to be athletic, and this one is moving very well. Good stride, clean, parallel lines coming towards us. Good.
It's our Tibetan Mastiff. Again, a late arrival here, but a little bit of information. This dog is owned by M.D. Reeves from Newquay in Cornwall, and it's Spirels Alexia Korsvig. This is the Siberian Husky.
Now, this is the lightest of the Arctic sled dogs, and this is bred for speed. So it's lighter in build, lighter in bone, not as much substance. This one keenly alert being handled, it's just a little unsettled, perhaps it has been rushed in a little.
As we've said, the judging really tight to get in this early for the group, but they've all managed it.
Farrelleth just making friends with it, they're getting it to relax.
Who carried diphtheria serum 650 miles from Anchorage to epidemic with Nome in 1925.
And another breed which is absolutely functional in its build, so it's not burdened with substance for going at fast speeds. It's fairly light and wiry, but the coat is protective, sharply pricked and furred ears, and that tail carried like a plume there.
This is the giant schnauzer. His name is Pico. He's a 4-year-old dog owned by Norma Rylands from Doncaster, handled in the ring by her and bred by Joanna Fries.
In the 17th century, giant schnauzers
very smart, square outline, hard top line, and topped by a wiry top coat, protective undercoat. Another of the German breeds and highly adaptable. It's been a tracking dog and a guard dog, used by the forces, highly intelligent dogs. The largest of the Schnauzer family. We've seen the miniature Schnauzer in the utility group and the standard Schnauzer. This is the giant. Again, it should carry that top line, slightly sloping from the withers. Tail carriage a little low there.
Really well known for its tracking skills. Ladies and gentlemen, the best of breed winning giant Schnauzer.
So Mrs. Summerfield now has to make a short list from this lovely selection of dogs. Well, you've seen them all. What's she going to pick? 8 or 9? Let's wait and see. So Mrs. Summerfield now will have a good walk down the line again, as she did at the beginning, but now she's had her hands on these dogs, she's got a really good idea of what she thinks is best compared to its template, what its standard says it should be. She's very experienced, she awards CCs in 147 breeds, so she really does know her stuff and has judged all the groups here at Crufts.
This is like a revision moment, reminding herself of what she's seen when going over the dogs on the hands-on inspection.
Can I ask, Frank, when you were judging the utility group, at this stage, did you think you knew where your winner was?
No, I didn't, actually, because it was quite an even group. But you get an idea of what is going to be in your shortlist.
Yes.
This is what you're thinking about at this time.
Well, the eyes of the dog world are on her here. This is the world's greatest dog show.
A very imposing Leonberger, very handsome.
It is, and moved nicely as well.
It's really marvellous to be back on television.
The young Mastiff, she did look a youngster, and a relatively young Newfoundland.
Yes, 26 months. As I say, they don't really mature all that early. She's just touching again, just to make sure she's got a good understanding of what that dog's like.
And looking at the maturity of the rib cage and body, Peter.
Portuguese water dog.
See how the handler holds the tail in the correct position. Looking at the head and expression of the Rottweiler.
It's an impressive group, always, I think, the working group, because these are the big dogs. They really are the giants of the dog world, and some spectacular animals we've seen. And that St. Bernard was impressive, a young one there. She's enjoying the Tibetan Mastiff as well, she likes that.
And then our later rivals at the end of the line, the Siberian, who did look a little unsettled, and the...
Mrs. Summerfield now is going to make a decision on her shortlist. It's a decision she knows she has to get right. She's going to pick her best in group from her shortlist. Just having another look along the line. Am I certain? Have I really made the right decisions here? Is there anything I want to have another look at?
And she'll be deciding how many she wants in. Usually 8 to 10 is the...
I think she likes that Tibetan Mastiff, and I think she likes the St. Bernard as well. Moved well scored in 1971. You never know. And then to the NEC in 1991. Certainly giving them a good look over, that's for sure.
Right, coming to the start of the line, and I think she'll pull out from this end now.
Quite deliberate move now.
The Alaskan Malamute comes in first, and the Bernese.
Bernese was very pretty indeed.
The Bouvier and the Bull Mastiff forward.
Gosh, she's picking out from the front, isn't she, here?
And the Dobermans called in.
We've got 5 chosen here, all from those early letters in the alphabet. Oh, she's walking Long past walk. My Newfoundland. That's
the
a shame.
The Rottweiler.
I should take the Rottie.
Clean, dry lines on that dog.
And the Tibetan Mastiff to complete the list.
So, thank you very much to those best of breed winners.
She's picked eight.
Please, ladies and gentlemen, as they leave the ring, can you put your hands together? What a wonderful crowd they have.
Yeah. Very appreciative crowd here, enjoying that. I can't count, she's only picked seven.
So I think they'll all go back now and then we'll have a chance to see them moving out and back again.
Now she's going to go along the line again and then she will move them all. Well, very interesting selection there, but I do think it's a spectacular, lovely, lovely group.
Now, Alaskan Malamute is going to send them out and back and round the ring. So she'll be checking on the accuracy of their movement in the forehand and hindquarters.
There it goes. Well, the audience loved it. He got a great round and it came into the ring. This is Jason. This two-year, 7-month-old dog.
And she comes back into position. And now it's a full circuit. And here the judge will be looking for the length of stride, getting the hocks well underneath it and holding the firm top line. All important in the movement and anatomy of the dog. Big cheers for the Bernese Mountain Dog from the Meadowpark Kennel up in Rochdale.
Yes, very, very lovely dog.
In gleaming condition.
A nice run round for the Bernese. A breeze is the name. Is it going to be a breeze for for this bitch today?
I do believe this is the one that was best of breed last year as well. Yeah.
The Bouvier Wanderer.
And the Bouvier, this is Floyd, 3-year-old dog.
Very workmanlike, strong. That matte coat on top of him.
They all have their fans here. They're all getting good applause. There doesn't seem really to be a favourite. Perhaps the Malamute, I don't know. But the audience applause doesn't necessarily mean anything to the judge. This is the Bull Mastiff. This is 5-year-old Minnie. This dog, Norwegian dog. Owned by Hilda Kelby.
Deep in concentration, Ferulith now. She's splitting hairs between these last seven dogs. Striding out. This is where the handlers have to keep calm and keep their nerves at bay.
And now we get to the letter D for the Doberman. They're all early in the alphabet, these, but the Doberman, this is Satchmo, this 3-year-old dog owned by Sue Thorne from Gloucestershire.
Yes, and a beautiful, crisp, hard outline. Nothing loose about the dog's top line.
Popular choice yet again. This is going to be a very interesting decision.
And clean front action.
All these handlers hoping to become best in group here. This is the Rottie. This is Max, 5-year-old Max. Graham Lees from Falkirk in Scotland.
And another lovely, hard top line. It's what we call a dry dog. They should have no loose skin on them. They should be dry and athletic. Very composed performance.
And finally the Tibetan Mastiff. This is Chodak. This 5-year-old dog, Richard Gardner, brought him from South Wales here. What an achievement for them. Impressive looking dog.
This is a strong muzzle and lovely expression on this dog. And the handler taking at just the right pace so he keeps his coordination and balance. If they rush them, then they lose the top line and outline. Very clever handling.
And that's the shortlist, just seven of them.
Seven,
the boards are coming out. That means Mrs. Sunfield has made her decision, called for the boards. Where's she going to go? Alaskan Malamute, Bernese Mountain Dog, Bouvier de Flandre, Bull Mastiff, Doberman, Rottweiler, Tibetan Mastiff.
One last look. And
what's this moment like for Mrs. Summerfield, Frank?
Tense, I would think.
Yep. Yeah. She doesn't look tense. She looks like
no,
here.
She's made her mind up.
She's got it. So the winner, it's going to be the Bernese. It is. Breeze, the Bernese from Rochdale in Lancashire. Handled by Mr. Gary Dubdall. Owned by Mrs. B. Mayer and Mrs. Carol Hartley Mayer. What a moment. Best in group, the Bernese Mountain Dog.
Incidentally, they won the Breeders' Group competition yesterday, Peter, this kennel. A marvellous weekend for
them. Oh, fantastic. What a wonderful week for them, for Crufts. The Bouvier de Flandre takes second, is the reserve.
And third place?
Group two, I should call it.
And third place is the Rottweiler.
Third place, the Rottweiler. This is Max, the five-year-old.
And in fourth spot, it's the Bull Mastiff.
The Bull Mastiff gets group four. Well, I'm delighted to see that Bernese there. Such a fine-looking dog. Wonderful markings on it. Oh, my word, what a splendid thing. And to have seen four of them walking around as we did yesterday in the Breeders' Stakes, well, tremendous.
Marvellous weekend for the mares.
And so, the award now to be made to the best in group.
And a beautiful shot of the Rottweiler's head and expression there.
The presentation actually being made now in the ring. And if I can find my piece of paper, I would tell you exactly who it was.
Gary the handler. Just qualified as a vet, very keen on the breed and helps the mares in their kennel.
Yes, finally got down to that. The award presented by Mrs. Mary Hambledon, and Anne MacDonald escorted her into the ring.
Mary Hambledon, the breeder of the great Marbleton boxers and pugs now, but she's been a marvellous model for the breeders.
Mrs. Summerfield walking down the line, congratulating those that she's given their awards.
Now she'll just have time for a little rest before she comes back to compete for best in show.
And it's not that long away now. Around about 7:30 UK time. Lap of honour for the Bernese Mountain Dog. Breeze.
Beautiful picture.
A very popular winner here in the ring. Well, I think the shortlist was a popular shortlist.
Four very balanced dogs, clean outlines, high quality selection.
But we still haven't determined how the seventh dog is coming through to join the others in the best in show competition, because that'll be determined by the winner of the pastoral group, which is just about to come into the ring. And I know Frank Kane's going to stay here to talk about these, but I'm going to hand over to my colleague.